two.
So we started to work on taking the blues. Yes, the blues. We're starting to work on taking the blues moves that we know so far and actually social dancing them and changing them to the music. So one we first started with just an open hand connection and sort of like playing with the idea of like getting into this connection and dancing to music and like really using movements and adding whatever variations, but really playing with the movement and more. It could be head, it could be shoulders, and also walking with it. So I'll be walking with it, and I'll be doing some shoulders, but I don't impact her. And I'm doing some hips, maybe some hips with this kind of twisting movement.
Yeah, what we did for the shoulders, yeah, I go over.
Yeah.
It was the move, which moves like this. It
yeah.
was hip, step, hip, step, hip, step, hip, step. So when I said that, I really go back on the leg I'm standing on, and all my body here is really back. So then I could really use this hip, and there is no weight over there. I just like called it to balance myself. And if I do from here, so all my weight is on the side, on the back, and you just hip, and then I step and shift my weight here. And then I kind of do fast and slow, fast and slow. Ha, 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 ha. Yeah.
Leaders, we gave a little kind of variation to just stand on one side, so you see my arms are here, and when I turn, all I do is I bring myself closer on the left side, so I don't affect me. So I bring myself closer on this side, and then I stand with my butt on my right, over my right leg. I make it old, like way farther over so that my butt is free and it doesn't affect your movement. So here, as I'm doing this butt movement, I start to bring it into my foot, and I move it real slow, and it starts to be more bluesy, and I can include it into my head and do double time. So basically, you gotta really get way over that leg, and then let that butt be free first, and then let that butt actually move the leg. And my arm do this. Okay, so that's what we did for like kind of the free kind of style. Then we added the position where leaders bring up their left, which brings up the followers right. And as it happens, you block her at the hip here, and then start to go side to side, and side, and side, and side. You can open up even more by letting go, and just going hip side to side. And then we can start moving, like side to side, together, playing around with the head. Maybe switching or going the same way. I'm playing with that and then coming back around and collecting.
Yeah.
That's one way. We also talked about the leader's version. So you would do a surprise attack and go, boop it up, boom. I shoot. And you can do it this way. Surprise attack is that the leaders lift up their right, followers will follow with the left, because it's going to happen. Leader's going to turn in and bring it back down and move this way.
Yeah.
Now, you can do a lot of movements. Leaders, you're going to hug yourself so that you don't bring the follower in like this. You're going to hug yourself so the follower's going to have a lot of space back, and you're going to move how you like. You can do this move if you want. You can do a lot of different moves that we do.
Yeah.
And you can also combine the first two. So we had the first one, moving it real slow, then hop into the second one, moving it real slow. Yep. We had another variation just from this hand, where the leader rolls in, and the hand goes right on the shoulder. And from here, the follower can feel the movement on the shoulder. If I turn this way, we're going to turn this way. Same thing, you can see that as my shoulder goes, it's connected here. Then we're going to turn this way. We can play with it. We can do it together, but the she not in fear of my life being like falling down to the ground?
I could just stand or I could join.
So you can add that wherever you want to music.
The drags.
And then the drags. Yes. So then we went to the harder stuff, which is that we wanted to connect with leaders kind of go like this, turn their body in and connect.
And do the hug follow around the back.
Yes. So from here we have this kind of arm dip connection. Here I hug her all the way to her left shoulder blade if I can, and it's not squeezing, I just hug so that wherever I move she can just feel where I'm going.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you might want to practice just that.
And here I have the feeling of paper clip. So I close my arm and bring my elbow down, so I really feel the connection here, and I follow the tension with all my upper body, so then I really could follow any direction straight away.
So now we're going to give us space to do free movement down below. We bend backwards, and it's not that we're trying to hold this shape. We have lots of freedom movement down here, so we're quite relaxed on the body. Yeah. So from here, if you see, my head goes straight across this way and her head is on the other side. And from here, I can do a pulse walk like this. And then if I want to do a long stride, I'll go down on one leg and I won't come back up, and I'll slide up and then I'll pulse again. Yeah. So then I'll go on the left, let's say, down. So that's a way to use this and continue a circle. We can also make the strides shorter, and we can do them over and over again. So we go pulsing, and we can stride in a circle. So we go down, stride, down, stride, down, stride, down, stride, down, stride, down, stride, down, stride. And if we really play with it, do-ba-da-ba, I can really go like this. Down, stride, down. So you can really play with this idea in the end if you're playing with the connection that's on this side.
Yeah, also you can play